Hello everyone and welcome back to Bitwig Studio and Music Production. Like all of these videos, this is completely optional. You don't have to watch this. I'm going back and recording it at a different time, which is why it's not fitting in the numbers of our series. But if you're going through the playlist, you will find this video in the right place. And what I wanted to do was talk about harmonics yet again. I know it's like I'm beating a dead horse with this, but the truth is, with so many different types of synthesis techniques, if you have a good grasp on the harmonic series and understand how harmonics work, then you're going to be able to synthesize any sound you want without having to just kind of go through and follow the steps that somebody else is taking who probably understands harmonics, and that's the only real difference. So I wanted to use Ableton for this and the operator so I could show you guys some interesting things with harmonics and, you know, why you don't necessarily need to buy like a super big and fancy wavetable synthesizer when you can generate and make your own unique wavetables and your own unique wave shapes very simply on your own. And when we're going and using Bitwig, we're going to be using a lot of different techniques since we don't have the ability to just draw in wave shapes we want. But we're going to go through, talk about this here, and hopefully some of it will make sense to you. We've already talked about a number of different wave shapes. The most simple of all being the sine. And here inside of the operator, we can see that this is indicating our fundamental here, and we can look at it inside of the smexoscope. Now, if we remember, the triangle wave is odd-ordered harmonics at a pretty steep slope, a pretty steep cutoff. And we can see here, we have that visual representation right here. And we see that that makes a triangle wave shape. We can go to the saw. Let's see if they have a good one. Let's use the saw 16. And we can see, even in odd order harmonics, cutting off like so, if we want one that's a little bit better, we can go to 64. And we can see how that goes all the way up the harmonic series there, all the way from bottom to the top. And with the square wave, we know that the square wave is odd harmonics, but it's going to go down a little bit smoother than the triangle wave. All right, so that's all well and good, and those are our normal wave shapes. But what if we want to make our own wave shape? What if we want to make something that's a little bit crazy? I'll show you how you can do that in just a second. So inside of the operator, we have the ability to draw our own wave shapes in. And I'm just going to go to user here to start, and I was messing with this earlier. And we can choose the number of bands right here, 16, 32, 64. Let's keep it at 16. We'll keep it at its easiest, and we're still going to see a whole lot of variation we can get. And right now, I have a sine wave. But let's say I want to make a square wave. I'm going to right-click, and I'm just going to select odd, so that as I'm drawing down here, we're going to only be hitting the odd harmonics. Let's watch how this changes. Watch how we start to get some curves. If I try to draw an even, I can't. So right there, we have kind of a basic square wave. Now, it's not perfect, and I only have 16 bands, but I could go to 64 bands, and I could try and draw a slope like so. That should be kind of similar to a square wave. But obviously, it's a little bit different. And that's one of the really cool things about this particular synthesizer is that, you know, this isn't a perfect square wave, but it's a unique square wave to me that I could use in my music then. Now, what if we don't want to follow the normal rules? We don't have to. Maybe for my even harmonics, I'll right click here, select even. I'm going to add some towards the top. Keep my fundamental all the way up though. That's will be helpful. So let's go back to odd. Let's do something weird. And if I was to pull up Massive right now and we were to go through all the wavetables, I guarantee you one is going to look very similar to this. Okay, and we can then go to our evens and get funky with those in some different spots. Or we can go to all and just draw something in. Okay, so I just want to make this quick video to show you how simple it is to generate your own unique waveforms. And in this particular case, we're using operator. We don't have operator in Bitwig, but we're going to be using distortion and filters and some other tools that's going to give us this much flexibility on controlling the harmonic series and hopefully getting us some very unique sounds. So thank you for watching, and you'll hear from me again in the next lesson. Take care.